Hey everyone, it's the end of another week and you know what that means. It's time for another patch preview. This week we've got a lot to talk about, so let's dive right in. Marillo!
Can you give us a quick taste of the things we can expect in this update?
So the first thing I wanted to touch on was a couple of the items we've taken a look at this patch. Namely Heart of Gold and Wriggle's Lantern. Heart of Gold was giving multiplicative defensive stats on a gold over time item. That's pretty out of line if you compare it to other options, so we just removed one of those statistics. It no longer gives armor and just health. We hope this can be combined equally well with magic resist or armor on future items, and then later of course built into Randuin's Omen if you desire. The bigger change, however, is Wriggle's Lantern. We removed the ability for the proc on Wriggle's Lantern against minions to do the lifesteal component. What we saw is people in lane were using that proc to fill up between fights way quicker than they would for an item of that gold level. So we really wanted to make sure we were reducing that lane abuse case while not nerfing it for jungle. So increased the lifesteal by 4%, made the proc not do the lifesteal component as well.
Speaking of Wriggle's Lantern, Teemo is a champion that buys Wriggles a lot. Are there any Teemo nerfs in store even after the Wriggles tweaks?
We wanted to do a couple of adjustments to Teemo. Primarily, we were seeing some stuff in really high elo where Teemo was split pushing kind of with impunity. He'd go split push a side tower where no one was at, and due to his high mobility, ability to lay down mushrooms everywhere, and his passive stealth, he was slipping away from almost any situation, so there's no risk. So we did a couple of really light nerfs just to hit that specific interaction. We've increased the reload time on his mushrooms ever so slightly, just to make it so he has a bit smaller of a field in a short-term scenario than he does currently. And also increased the cooldown on the active of Move Quick from 13 to 22 seconds. This will make it so he still has a combat utility of being able to dart in and out when he's in danger, but hopefully we'll make it so he moves across the map a little bit slower, as well as can't chain escape from somebody who comes after him on the split.
So some of the community is a little upset with me because I'm not playing Pantheon much anymore. Taking a little break, I switched to Nocturne. I love him, he's amazing. What kind of buffs are you gonna give him this update?
So Nocturne, we kind of wanted to give him a little time to gestate after we released him. You know, assassins are very snowbally characters. They tend to kind of be easy to pick up and play. So the day one jitters, kind of to speak of, you know, nerf this guy, he's super overpowered, can be a little misleading. After looking for a couple weeks, he probably is a little overpowered in a couple areas, so we wanted to hit a few things. We reduced some of the bonus damage on the trail when he stands on it, the bonus attack damage he receives. That was giving him a little too many free stats. We fixed a bug with the fear dot spell, where you couldn't teleport out of the leashing. That should help, hopefully, with characters who have blinks escape that, as well as decrease the range of that leash a little bit. Finally, the rank 1 version of the ultimate had its range decreased by 100, hopefully making warding and kind of good positioning gameplay early in the lane have a better effect against Nocturne's early jungle ganks.
Aside from buffing Cassiopeia and fixing some bugs on Twisted Fate, we are actually nerfing tanky DPS some this patch. What's our plan for those champions?
A good example of what we're trying to do is some of the stuff you see on Renekton. We're generally lowering the base damages down and upping the ratios by quite a bit, hopefully encouraging a little bit more offensive builds on him. It's kind of a thing we want to check out and see if that's actually the problem in a large live fire environment. We do have some long-term changes that are really disruptive and experimental that we're testing internally right now. We weren't comfortable with a lot of those yet because they need a lot more testing. However, these changes were very safe and seemed to address the problem in at least a meaningful way. So we wanted to go ahead and give those to the players now.
Thanks for tuning in to this episode of the Patch Preview Series. Please subscribe up here and leave a comment below about what change you're looking forward to the most. We're going to pick 5 lucky winners who did both those things and give you a free t-shirt from the League of Legends store.